president, who is joining us tonight for the first time as our president, Lord Geddes with Lady Geddes. And we have the deputy lieutenant of Wiltshire, Shirley Ludford, which is fabulous. And we also marvellously have the mayor of Bradford-on-Avon, her husband David, who is councillor for Trowbridge. So we've got a really good collection of people in the house. If you were listening to Radio 3 this morning at 8:45, we got a massive plug for this concert hall and also for the concert. So that's great. You might be wondering why we are doing a coronation concert so far before May the 6th, I believe. The reason being was that it was planned way back for the Queen's Jubilee, but then the dear Queen passed away, so we just revamped it and it morphed into a coronation concert, which is going to cover coronation anthems from the time of George II right up to the present Queen. So let us start then with the coronation anthem by George Frederick Handel called Zadok the Priest, written for the coronation of George and Caroline of Brunswick.
Thank you.
master of the music at the time when George Handel was alive. He would have got the job of writing Zadok the Priest, but Handel arrived when George I was still alive. He was immediately appointed master of the music. When Handel died, Boyce did get the job, and he became master of music to George III. And for him, he wrote some coronation music, and they asked him to set Zadok the Priest to music. He said, no, not a chance. He said, what Handel wrote was absolutely irreplaceable, could never be bettered. So we're going to play a symphony by William Boyce, just to give him some credit, because he's a wonderful English Baroque composer. It's quite interesting, in the royal connection, that when Harry and Meghan got married, the piece that they walked out to was a symphony by William Boyce. This is the symphony number 5, very charming, and it lasts only 8 minutes, so it's one of the shortest symphonies ever.
Thank you.
And we're doing the third one, which is called The King Shall Rejoice, which is probably the biggest, longest, and comes in four full movements with a big close with absolutely fabulous trumpets and Handel's very favourite word in the whole world, Alleluia. So this is called The King Shall Rejoice.
Thank you.
excuse me, the Covent Garden Operatic Society. The Royal Opera House, Covent Garden didn't exist in those days. And they commissioned Elgar, because he'd written this tune that the king was very fond of, the future king, King Edward VII. And it was Land of Hope and Glory, which he thought was a really splendid song. And he wanted to put words to it, you see. So they got A.C. Benson to write some words. And Elgar said, well, why don't we just do the whole thing and write the big ode? And Benson, you can write all the lyrics, and I'll write all the music. Now, some of it is very loud, very brash, and very much of the period. You know, it's very jingoistic. But other bits are incredibly tender and incredibly sensitive. And Elgar added two pieces for various queens as the king died and other monarchs came to the throne. So that there is some very tender music and some very not quite bombastic, because Elgar is too much of a genius for that, but what might be considered nowadays to be slightly over the top and aren't we splendid and fantastic and better than everybody else. By the way, I think we're winning 1-0 against Senegal. What? 2-0. Well, I think we can puff ourselves up a little bit. So here it is. This is the great Coronation ode by Edward Elgar. The first movement is nearly 10 minutes long, but then it does calm down. national anthem to Her Late Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and to welcome His Majesty King George III. We're going to sing slightly changed words. Jar! Sorry, Your Majesty, cut that. And His Majesty King Charles III. So we're going to do a version of the national anthem where we sing a little tribute to the passing of the Queen. And then, if you feel so emboldened, please stand up and sing the second verse, which will be the normal words, but with God Save the King. And they will be up.